Hello friends, today we are going to show you demo of liquid filtering machine. This is a liquid filtering machine 8x6 zero hold up model. Zero hold up means the reverse flow. The flow of liquid will be from bottom to top, so there will be very little wastage. And this is sparkler type filter. Let me introduce the machine parts. This is the power button to switch on the machine, switch on and switch off the machine. There is a gear pump. We can also give different kind of pumps like centrifugal pump or a lobe pump depending on the material you want to filter out. And there is a 1 HP motor below this cover that operates this pump. And this pump is self-priming, so it can suck the material directly from your tank. This gear pump is self-priming. Some centrifugal pumps are not self-priming, but if the inlet is in flooded condition, means it's from the bottom of your tank, so the product is in flooded condition, then it can self prime the product. And there comes the pressure gauge. This is the pressure gauge where it shows the pressure inside the filtering vessel, filtering tank. And there is a valve just near the pressure gauge. This is just to transfer the product. Suppose if you want to use this pump just to transfer the product from one tank to another, you don't want to filter it, just you want to use the pump as a transfer pump. So you can close this valve which is going to the filter tank and just open this valve, so product will flow from this tank to this outlet without filtering. But if you want to filter out, just close this valve, the bypass valve, and let the product flow by opening that valve to the filtering tank, and from that product will get filtered and then transferred via this outlet. So this valve also needs to be open while you do the filtering process. Now we have one unfiltered material. Basically here we use the water, and in the water we just mix some amount of wheat flour. We can put little more to show you. This is the wheat flour. Remove the pipe and put it inside. We already put it, you can see the we already mixed the wheat flour to make it little, the product is little blurry, you can see, because its flour is mixed inside. And here we have one more tank to get the filtered product. So let's see how to operate it. Now this model is 8x6, means there are total 6 number of plates which are in 8 inch diameter. The plate diameter is 8 inch. This can filter around 400 to 600 liters per hour depending on the product viscosity and the solid particles, solid wastage which need to be filtered out, the quantity of solid wastage. So now currently we have used a single phase motor in this machine. We can also give 3 phase motor. Let's operate. Initially we need to switch on this the main supply, so the product will start sucking from the tank. And initially one can pull this safety valve for few time so that the air inside the filtering tank get removed completely and the suction will be faster. Once the air get removed completely from this filtering media tank, the suction will be very fast. Insert that pipe little more inside. You can see the filtering is happening. The product got sucked from here and it's coming here in this tank. We can further remove the air because I feel there is still air. We are taking trial with very less amount of product. It's hardly 20 liter, you can see. So when the product is more, the speed will be very fast once the air get removed. Once the liquid droplet start coming out from this valve, that means the complete air got removed. Now the product got finished, so we are switching off the machine. You can just hold this initially for certain seconds. So once the liquid coming out from this point, that means there is no air left in this vessel. Now the suction will be at full speed because as there is no air left inside. Now you can see the product got filtered in this tank. Now if you ask me why the color, there is no difference in the color, because this machine only filters out the solid particles. It don't change the product color, which because some particles get so much dissolved, and it also basically depends, the color depends on the particles as well as some other properties of the liquid. So we can't guarantee you that filtering a product can change the color. Obviously it will change, but it's not like it will make the product completely without colorless or something. That depends why the product has that color. If it is because of the solid particle, then you will get the good color, means colorless product. But if it's not just because of the solid particle, there may be other process which you need to take into account to clear the color of the product, which especially oil customer asks that I want to look my oil very transparent and bright. So that depends on other process also. And currently we are using 10 micron filter pads, so if these particles lesser than that size will obviously get passed, so we will get this color. If you want to clean, if you want to filter more fine particle, then you have to use that kind of filter pads. So still, let's see the result. We will check the material which we filtered out by taking the product in this tank. You can see there are no particles, there are no solid particles, it's plain liquid. Even you can see at the bottom of the tank there is no deposit, there are no particles. And obviously it got sucked from that tank. In that tank you can see there is deposited particles, solids, or you can call it waste, below the bottom of the tank, at the bottom of the tank. But here there is no such particles. Still, to show you, we will open this filter tank now to show you where all particle got filtered out, which are above 10 micron got filtered out in this tank. To open this tank, we'll open these four screws, four bolts, the clamp bolt given around the diameter of this vessel. Now this complete machine structure is in stainless steel SS304, and on request we can make the contact part in SS316 or SS316L, depending on the product demand, the customer demands, because some products are corrosive. So to withstand that, we can give the contact part in SS316 or SS316L or even higher on request. And the pump type also we can change according to product. Now this, there are the, you can see the silicone seals. Now this happened, the product was filled inside the tank because we have not removed the product completely. We switched off the machine in between, and this tank level is higher than the filtering tank. So the product, by gravity flow, it was filled inside the tank. We have to keep the machine on for some time to get all products sucked in, and this pipe we can lift it in the air so all product get removed. Anyway, now we are opening the filter assembly to show you the filtered particles. This was the center rod to separate all plates, and there are also four tie rods which you can remove. Now once you remove these tie rods, you can separate each plate. These white pads, these are the filter pads. These pads are available in different material and different micron size, and some are reusable, some are use and throw types, one time use. Now you can see here on pad there is some thing deposited. You can see the things. This is the wheat flour which we mixed into the water. Remove this plate. Now we will lift the plate one by one to see the result on another plate. You can see on every plate you will find this kind of thing deposited. And as this product is flowing from bottom to top, the very first the plates which are at the bottom will have most of the deposit. You can see, and this deposit is very very fine. It can just dissolve in the water if I just shake it. So you can understand how fine it is. But even if we use these pads with lesser micron, we can filter out even more. So it all depends on the pad micron size. Now when to open this vessel and when to clean the machine. As you start filtering the product from the source tank, the dust get deposited on the pad, and after some time it's impossible for liquid to flow because the liquid needs lots of pressure to get filtered to flow through this point, because there is lots of dust already got deposited, which jam pack the passage to pass the liquid. In that condition, the pressure will start increasing in this pressure gauge. This is glycerin filled pressure gauge. Once the pressure reaches on higher side, it's a signal that you have need to stop the machine and clear the cake deposited. We call it cake depositing capacity of this machine. This model has around 2 to 3 kg of cake deposit capacity. So we need to stop the machine, we need to open the assembly and remove or replace the pad or clean the pad and refit it again to start the machine again. So this was all the process we need to do with the machine to filter the product, like sugar syrup, juices, chemicals, or any kind of liquid which have oils, some sediments or some particles. Now it depends which size of micron size of pad you need to use, depend on your product and the particle size you want to filter. If you have any further question with this machine, kindly get back to us on our email ID mentioned below the video, and there is a WhatsApp number given in the description of the video. You can just send us the inquiry with your complete details, what product you want to filter, how much liter you want to filter in per hour, and what micron size you want to filter. Suppose you are not sure with the micron size, then you need to experiment with these filter pads. We can offer you different size filter pad. You can do the trial batches and see which size is very good for you, or either you can send your product for the lab test to know the particle size. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe our channel to get more updates like this, more products like this. And if you have any question, you are welcome to ask on our WhatsApp or email account. Thank you.